Welcome back. So I found on the shelf behind me a piece of ash. It's 80 mil thick, and this is around, let's measure it, 5.5 inches, so that's 140 mil. So I remembered why I put this aside. So there is a pit. This was a piece of quite a wide slab which I had, and here you can see a big split, and on the other side here as well. So basically, if I would put a axe through here, this will split into two, which actually I could try. I think it will split. So we can see what I can get out of it now. Now, as I thought, with a little bit of pounding, it split quite nicely. So there is not any other split apart from this one. So if I go from this side, then I could probably lift this part as well. Okay. Now you can see I removed all of the splits, at least this major one, and now I can assess what I can do from these two pieces. Now I can make really shallow bowls. Probably with this one I'll go with spindle blank, something like this. Although it's actually quite tempting to make small dish. So probably do that here as well. So I'll go on the bandsaw, and you see me how I cut this. Okay, so two bigger bowl blanks. You see about the shape here, this slope, once I start to chew it up. Two smaller ones, close diameter, and I have this little piece left over. Just going to keep it as it is. This is dry, so maybe a small finial or something, button, whatever it can serve. So back at the lid, so I drilled the hole. I'm going to start with the smaller bowls. This screw is almost the right depth. Just first, as always, to chew it up and get close to a ball shape. So I'm through here at the rim. You can probably see this portion is true. Can turn it off. So still a little bit more to go. This is my smaller chuck, this actually here, so still a little bit more down. Shoe scraper. And to scrape the bottom here as well. Now I can set the foot. To see if I need to shear scrape. This was flat, a little bit rougher, so what I'll do actually here is be a little bit more gentle, and then from here I can shear scrape. Okay, so that's the ball number one done. And I'll finish these off the lathe. Again, spindle gouge. Time to time you see me hold the gouge like this. I do it like so to deflect the shavings to fly into my face. So I'm all almost through at the rim. I think I need to go a little bit more. Just a little bit more. So now gently this corner, and now I can shear scrape the rest of it. See the surface before I sand, although that feels quite good. Love this olive part in this ash. This was lovely slab which I had. Wall number two. Now actually I didn't notice this, I lost a bit of definition here. So I didn't notice this before. I lost a little bit of definition here. Up the face. Okay, so that's quite nice surface. I just want to see. Yeah, that's quite nice depth. That's looking quite nice. The other one. Ash is a wood that works quite beautifully. More at the bottom. A little bump here. Okay, that's the other one done. So these two are now done. The two bigger ones I'm going to do in the next video. So this isn't too long of a video. And you can see here how they are quite similar in pattern, because they were sitting like this in the board, in the wood. So this olive wood part texture in this ash goes through both of them, since they were like this in a piece. And you can see that lovely straight pattern, because this is a quarter sawn. And yeah, quite nice two little bowls, and the two bigger ones as well should be quite nice, and they're quite similar in shape and size. You see all four of them once they're finished in the next video.